Ahab. Ahab was the seventh king of Israel since Jeroboam I, the son and successor of Omri, and the husband of Jezebel of Sidon, according to the Hebrew scriptures. The Hebrew Bible presents Ahab as a wicked king. He is criticized for following the ways of his wife Jezebel, killing his subject Naboth, and leading the nation of Israel into idolatry. The existence of Ahab is historically supported outside the Bible. Shalmaneser III documented 853 BC that he defeated an alliance of a dozen kings in the Battle of Karkar. One of these was Ahab. Ahab became king of Israel in the 38th year of Asa, king of Judah, and reigned for 22 years, according to 1 Kings. William F. Albright dated his reign to 869 to 850 BC, while Lee R. Thiele offered the dates 874 to 853 BC. Most recently, Michael D. Coogan has dated Ahab's reign to 871 to 852 BC. Omri, Ahab's father and founder of the short-lived Omri dynasty, seems to have been a successful military leader. He is reported in the text of the Moabite Mishnah Stele to have oppressed Moab for many days. During Ahab's reign, Moab, which had been conquered by his father, remained tributary. Ahab was allied by marriage with Jehoshaphat, who was king of Judah. Only with Aram Damascus is he believed to have had strained relations. Ahab married Jezebel, the daughter of the king of Tyre. 1 Kings 16-22 tells the story of Ahab and Jezebel, and indicates that Jezebel was a dominant influence in Ahab and strove to spread idol worship of Baal in Israel. Ahab lived in Samaria, the royal capital established by Omri, and built a temple and altar to Baal-Tyr. He was succeeded by Ahaziah and Jehoram, who reigned over Israel until Jehu's revolt of 842 BC. The Battle of Karkar is mentioned in extra-biblical records, and was perhaps at Apamea, where Shalmaneser III of Assyria fought a great confederation of princes from Cilicia, northern Syria, Israel, Ammon, and the tribes of the Syrian desert, 853 BC, including Ahab the Israelite, Ahab Beusar al-Aa, and Hadadezer Adadidri. Ahab's contribution was estimated at 2,000 chariots and 10,000 men. In reality, however, the number of chariots in Ahab's forces was probably closer to a number in the hundreds, based upon archaeological excavations of the area and the foundations of stables that have been found. If, however, the numbers are referring to allies, it could possibly include forces from Tyre, Judah, Edom, and Moab. The Assyrian king claimed a victory, but his immediate return and subsequent expeditions in 849 BC and 846 BC against a similar but unspecified coalition seem to show that he met with no lasting success. According to the Tanakh, however, Ahab with 7,000 troops had previously overthrown Ben-Hadad and his 32 kings, who had come to lay siege to Samaria, and in the following year obtained a decisive victory over him at Aphek, probably in the plain of Sharon at Antipatris, 1 Kings 20. A treaty was made whereby Ben-Hadad restored the cities which his father had taken from Ahab's father, and trading facilities between Damascus and Samaria were granted. Jezreel has been identified as Ahab's fortified chariot and cavalry base. In the biblical text, Ahab has 5 important encounters with prophets. 3 years later, war broke out east of the Jordan River, and Ahab with Jehoshaphat of Judah went to recover Ramoth-Gilead from the Aramaeans. During this battle, Ahab disguised himself, but he was mortally wounded by an unaimed arrow, 1 Kings 22. The Hebrew Bible says that dogs licked his blood, according to the prophecy of Elijah. But the Septuagint, the Greek translation of the Old Testament, adds that pigs also licked his blood, symbolically making him unclean to the Israelites, who abstained from pork. Ahab was succeeded by his sons, Ahaziah and Jehoram. Jezebel's death, however, was more dramatic than Ahab's. As recorded in 2 Kings 9:30-34, Jezebel was confronted by Jehu, who had her servants throw her out the window, causing her death. 1 Kings 16:29-22:40 contains the story of Ahab's reign. This reign is one which faces opposition from several prophets of Yahweh throughout, as well as various consequences because of his marriage to Jezebel, because of his worship of Baal, disobedience to prophetic warnings and words, and also because of the murder of Naboth. The murder of Naboth, see Jezebel, an act of royal encroachment, stirred up popular resentment just as the new cult aroused the opposition of the Israelite prophets, including Elijah and Micaiah. Indeed, he is referred to, for this and other things, as being more evil than all the kings before him, 1 Kings 16:30. The followers of Yahweh found their champion in Elijah. His denunciation of the royal dynasty of Israel and his emphatic insistence on the worship of Yahweh and Yahweh alone, illustrated by the contest between Yahweh and Baal on Mount Carmel, 1 Kings 18, form the keynote to a period which culminated in the accession of Jehu, an event in which Elijah's chosen disciple Elisha was the leading figure. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.